morning to one and all present here. I begin my welcome speech with my Republic Day wishes, wishing you all a very happy Republic Day. It's my pleasure to be a part of this occasion. We are here to celebrate our 72nd Republic of our country. On this auspicious day, on the behalf of the Cruiser Academy, I extend a warm welcome to the chairperson, Mr. K.K. Rajan, principal, staff, parents and students. Now I request our principal, Mr. P. Damodaran, to deliver a short speech to us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I begin my talk with my Republic Day wishes. Wish you all a happy Republic Day. Republic Day has been celebrated every year in India on January 26 since 1950 to honor the date on which the Constitution of India came into effect. Today, India is celebrating its 72nd Republic Day. India was a colony of the British for over 200 years and became independent from the rule of the British Raj following the Indian independence movement. While India became independent on August 15, 1947, it still didn't have a permanent constitution, and Indian laws were based on a modified version of the British established Government of India Act 1935. However, 2 weeks later, on 29 August 1947, a drafting committee was appointed for the drafting of a permanent Indian constitution with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as chairman. After a lot of hard work, the constitution was finally drafted and January 26 was chosen as the day to declare India as a sovereign republic. The significance of January 26 is that on that day in 1929, the Indian National Congress made the well-known declaration of Indian independence, that is Purna Swaraj. And though the constitution came into force in 1950 with the democratic government system, it was adopted by the Indian Democratic Constituent Assembly on 26 November 1949. This completed the country's transition into becoming a sovereign republic. The draft of the constitution was submitted to the Indian Constituent Assembly on 4, 1947 in the month of November. Over the course of 166 days that were spread over 2 years, the 308 members of the assembly met in the sessions that were open to the public and made some modifications. Finally, on January 24, 1950, the assembly members signed two handwritten copies of the constitution, one in English and one in Hindi. And 2 days later, history was made. On that day, began Rajendra Prasad's first term of office as President of the Indian Union. The Constituent Assembly became the Parliament of India under the transitional provisions of the new constitution. January 26 is celebrated to commemorate the Indian Constitution replacing the Government of India Act 1935 as the governing document of India. And now it is celebrated across India with a lot of fervor. In Delhi, at Rajpath, magnificent parades by regiments of the Indian Army, Navy, Air Force, Police and paramilitary forces march, and there is also a display. India's defense prowess is on display with the latest missiles, aircraft and weapon systems. Beautiful tablets representing the beauty of all the states of India are also showcased during the parade. There are also sky shows by the Air Force which you can watch on televisions and enjoy. Thank you all for listening to my speech. Wish you all a happy Republic Day once again. Vande Mataram.
शीतला सस् मातरम् शुभ्रज्योत्स्ना पुलकितयामिनी पुल्लकुसुमित द्रुमदल शोभिनी सुहासिनी सुमधुर भाषिनी सुखदां वरदां मातरम् वंदे मातरम् वंदे मातरम्।
My dear friends, namaste. Greetings to you all on 72nd Republic Day. India was declared republic on 26 January 1950. So therefore this day was very important day in the history of the world. So why the government has chosen 26th January as the date to declare India as a republic day? Because on this day, 26th January 1930, India was declared independent by our national leaders. Even though British refused to give independence to us, Indians, they themselves declared India to be independent on this day, that is on 26 January 1930. That is why this day is always considered to be one of the most important days of Indian history. Today, I would like to talk about some of the important rights we have been given by the Indian Constitution on this day of Republic. We have fundamental rights. We are citizens of this country. We have all the right even to elect the chief executive of our country. We have all the right to form our own government. So every right is vested in our hands. Fundamental rights, there are many fundamental rights, like for example, right against exploitation, right to equality, right to freedom of religion, right to compulsory education. So likewise, we have right to life. So likewise, many rights we have. But there are some rights under which even there are some social evils in the society today under which we still struggle. So like, for example, exploitation. Still people are exploited. Women are exploited. Children are exploited. Laborers are exploited. Everywhere we see the exploitation. But we have the right called right to exploitation. But this is a fundamental right. But are we using this right to fight against this sort of exploitations? We don't. Why? Because we do not have the knowledge of many rights which preserve our rights. So like, for example, we have a right called constitutional remedy. We can question the government if the government fails to respect our fundamental rights. This constitutional remedy is a right which has been given to the people to approach the court if you find that your rights have been denied. And this act called constitutional remedy has very important writs. So like, for example, there are five writs which I would like to explain today in a very short. So number one, we have habeas corpus. That is, if an individual liberty is at risk or if a person is unlawfully arrested, we can approach the court for remedy. That is, if a person is arrested, he should be produced before the court immediately. A person who has been arrested, the person who arrests should have proper evidence for the arrest. Without evidence, if a person has been taken to the court can dismiss this appeal or he can punish the person who has arrested a person unlawfully. So such a right we have. Next is mandamus. This writ is used by the court to order the public official who has failed to perform his duty. If a police official is not responding to a complaint, for example, we can use mandamus, and through court we can make that particular person to respond. So nowadays it's very common when you go to any official with any work, if you ask him to do, he doesn't do it. Okay, but what we do, we try to bribe him. That's a mistake we do. Instead, we have to know what right we have and how we can make that particular person to work for us. So thirdly, we have prohibition. Under this writ, a higher court issues a prohibition writ against lower court if it functions beyond its powers. Say, for example, district court has its own powers, high court has its own powers, supreme court has its own powers, and then local government, local courts are there. Okay, every court has its own jurisdictions. So they have to act within the jurisdiction. They should not go beyond its jurisdiction. They should not misuse their powers. Okay, in case if it happens so, high court has all the right to prohibit. Okay, that is what this prohibition is all about. And this, and actually this law, this writ is also applicable for the officials also. Okay, in case if officials, if they misuse their powers, we can question them through this act, through this writ called prohibition. Next, fourthly, Sharishwari. This is used by higher court to limit the powers of the lower court. If a lower court takes a decision which is not within its powers, the higher court can dismiss its decisions. Say, for example, Nyay Panchayat. Some villages, they have Nyay Panchayat. Especially in North India, we find this very popular among the people in the villages, Nyay Panchayat. So what do? They punish. If a person has committed a small crime or a bigger crime, Nyay Panchayat, they punish. So that is illegal. That should not be done. It is the right of only of the court to decide the punishment of a citizen. So that is what they say. Even here also, likewise, like the way I told the prohibition, so likewise also, the court has its own limited powers within which they all have to the function. Finally, qua warranto. This writ is used to prevent a person from forcefully holding any office. Say, for example, somebody will be dismissed from the job, but yet he will be holding the office. So that is illegal. You should not do that. Whosoever he may be, even a deputy magistrate or whosoever it may be, or even an ordinary teacher may be, he has to leave the office once he is dismissed, once he is no more in the office. He cannot carry. That office belongs to somebody else. So he should respect. We have to come. Later, whatever we want to do, we can do it. But until then, we should know, we cannot carry the office. The court has to decide whether you can continue or not. Okay, so this is called qua warranto. Say for example, an official who was in a high rank, so after once he retires, he cannot exercise the same powers which he was exercising before. So that is something illegal. So we can make note of this, and then we can even file a case against him in the court. So likewise, my dear friends, we have so many rights, so many acts which are enlisted in our Indian Constitution to protect us. We also should know all these rights. Okay, including the fundamental rights, including the directive principles of state policy and this constitutional remedies. All this we have to know. Why I am saying we should know? Because this will make us a responsible citizens. We can raise our voice against injustice done to anybody in the society. But many of us, what we do? We are blind, including me. We see so many social evils happening in the society, but we just keep quiet because we do not know the rules and regulations. We feel that we will get caught. We'll unwantedly will be taken into risk, taken into task. So therefore, we avoid many of those things. But such things should not happen. We have to raise voice against the social evils. We have to fight for the justice. There are so many people who have been betrayed of their rights. So for them, we have to work. We have to work, and we have to make them, like especially for children who have been ill-treated by the elders. We can raise voice against such people. We can fight for the children. Fight for the children's freedom. So therefore, I insist that we all know these rights in a proper manner and remain with the justice and fight for justice. Even Gandhiji also said the same thing. Justice is the real weapon through which we can fight any evil. If you are just and if you know all these rules and regulations, we can fight for justice. So with this, I conclude my speech saying that the purpose of celebration of these days, like Republic as well as independence, to make us to realize that we are citizens of a democratic country and are free to exercise our rights without fear for the well-being of our nation. So therefore, my dear friends, our participation in these activities of the government is mandatory to make our nation the best and exemplary. Jai Hind.
Thank you. நிறங்களால் குணங்களால் மொழிகளால் வேறுபட்டிருப்பினும் நாம் எல்லாரும் இந்திய மக்கள் என்று ஒற்றுமையையும் நாட்டுப்பற்றையும் ஊட்டும் பாரதியின் பாடல் தொடர்கிறது. பாரத சமுதாயம், ராகம் பெஹாக், தாளமாதி.
Bye. நன்றி கூறுவது என்பது தமிழர்களின் பண்பாடு. அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். இந்த அருமையான தருணத்தில் உங்கள் அனைவரையும் சந்திப்பதில் பெரும் மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறேன். நமது குடியரசு தின விழா நமது பள்ளியில் சிறப்பாக நடைபெற்று முடிந்தது. இவ்விழாவை சிறப்பித்த நமது தாளாளர் அவர்களையும் பள்ளி நிர்வாகத்தினரையும் மற்றும் நம்மை நல்ல முறையில் வழிநடத்தும் நமது தலைமையாசிரியர் அவர்களையும் முதலில் வணங்கி இவ்விழாவை சிறப்பித்து தந்தமைக்காக நன்றியை கூறுகிறேன். மற்றும் இவ்விழா இன்னும் சிறப்பு பெற்றதாக அமைய வரவேற்புரை, நமது அரசியலமைப்பு சட்டத்தின் குடிமக்களின் உரிமைகள் பற்றிய விழிப்புணர்வு உரை, பாடல்கள், நடனம் என இன்னும் அதிக முக்கியத்துவத்தை சேர்த்து சிறப்பித்த அனைத்து ஆசிரிய பெருமக்களுக்கும் நன்றியை கூறுகிறேன். இந்த இக்கட்டான சூழ்நிலையிலும் மாணவர்களின் கல்வியில் முக்கியத்துவத்தை கொடுத்து பள்ளிக்கும் ஆசிரியர்களுக்கும் உறுதுணை செய்யும் எமது அருமை பெற்றோர்களுக்கும் இணைய வகுப்புகளை தவறாமல் பார்த்து கல்வி கற்கும் என் அன்பு மாணவ செல்வங்களுக்கும் நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். நமது பள்ளி ஆசிரியர்கள் மட்டுமின்றி அலுவலக பணியாளர்கள், உதவியாளர்கள், காவலர்கள், ஓட்டுநர்கள், நடத்துனர்கள் என அனைவருக்கும் இவ்விழாவை சிறப்பித்து தந்தமைக்காக நன்றி கூறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.